Now that we have some text boxes laid down on our page, we're going to start looking at how to format the text. I'm going to be on my type tool, and first I wanted you to kind of direct your attention to the control bar. This first set of options for changing your text are known as character formatting. They can be reached by selecting the A in your control bar, and it's this first set. If I hit the P, that first set changes. So now that first set is the paragraph formatting. Note that you can actually access both when you have a larger screen or a larger monitor like I do. But for our purposes, I am going to toggle back and forth to kind of emphasize these are character formatting. And then in the next video, we'll look at paragraph formatting. So let's get started with some type and work on formatting it. We're going to start with our type in a circle. So I'm going to click in there and hit Command A. Here's where I can change my font, and below you can see the options available in that typeface. So a quick little handy clue for you. If you select the font in your control bar, and just arrow down, I'm using the down arrow, you can kind of scroll through what each of those fonts would look like. I think that's a helpful way because sometimes it's hard to envision what would that font look like. I usually do this and just make notes, jot down a couple of names of fonts that I like. I really like that. This is kind of one of my new favorite fonts. And I have a lot of options for that. So let's go with this font. Now, when you're working with this type of reverse text, even if your style is saying, say your body copy is typically at 9, that's going to be really hard to read. So take it up a half a point or a full point for reverse type. And we can even take a look at that would look like going to white. Not too bad. So, we have our font selected. Let's play around with it. We're going to act like we have some text in here, and our style is just going to be to kind of bold some keywords. This option right here below our font size is the leading. And a good way to think of leading is it is the space between lines. So you select your text, and if I wanted this to be double spaced, I would, and there's not an option for 20, so we'll just type 20 in. So that would be double spacing my text. Next, you have some other options for type. So you can go in and let's say with our bold text, we not only want it to be bold, we also want it to be capitalized. So you can select capitalize, superscript, there's underline, strike through, subscript, and small caps. Continuing on down, we have kerning and tracking. Now, kerning and tracking are very similar. I'm actually going to hop over to Colorado when we do this. I'm going to make a copy of it. So what kerning and tracking do is deal with spacing. And the idea of it is to deal with spacing to make a font look better. So with kerning, we are dealing with the space between characters. So as opposed to selecting anything, you actually just click between the space. And then you can come up here, and we're going to do like a big example. So that would be 100 minus 100. So we're bringing those in tighter. Obviously, this is going to space them further apart. So sometimes what you can do is use kerning and tracking to help the appearance of a font that maybe looks like there's too much space, not enough space. It's very helpful. Tracking deals with the entire word. Now, if you're not going to remember it, use the visual clues. Notice that at kerning, there's a line between the V and A. That should lead you to think, space between characters. Tracking, it shows a whole letter and then an arrow beneath it. And that tracking deals with the space within the entire word. So that's the whole thing at 100, and that's the whole thing at 100. So you can see how that might be helpful if you have a strange font. The next two options up here I'm going to talk about are vertical and horizontal scale. And let's demonstrate what those are. So I'm going to take my vertical scale way up and then way down. So vertical scale deals with the height of the letters, and that should give you an indication of what horizontal scale is going to do, which is make the letters longer or skinnier. Now, here is the rule, and this is a rule of design. Don't mess with the horizontal and vertical scale. If the font designer would have wanted their font to look thusly, they would have designed it as such. If experts are looking at your design, they may not know, oh, well, they changed their horizontal scale to 125%. They might not know that, but they'll know it looks weird. They'll know it looks off. So it is best to avoid these two. Next up, you have your baseline shift. So if you want to increase the baseline shift of something, you can. This is a great thing to remember how to do when you have percents. That would be how you would make something 1.5%. So that is your basic character formatting.